Happy Good Friday to you all. The Stations of the Cross, or the Way of Sorrows, is an ancient tradition in the church, referring to a series of images that remind us of the journey of Jesus from his trial to Mount Calvary, crucifixion, death, and burial. The stations grew out of a desire to walk that same road in Jerusalem, walk down the traditional path that historians believe Jesus took. The object of the stations is to help the Christian faithful to make a spiritual pilgrimage, and as they do that, to consider the Passion of Christ. It has become perhaps one of the most popular devotions, and stations can be found in Western Christian churches, including Anglican churches, some Lutheran churches, Methodists, and Roman Catholic. The stations are up to 14 from the beginning to end, images of those stations of Jesus' journey, and then a series of readings, sometimes scripture, sometimes meditations on the meaning of that station. We have prepared 10 stations with an introduction and a conclusion to present to you this night. Stations of the Cross, the Way of Christ, the Way of Suffering. We'll conclude those stations with a solo, the Via Dolorosa, sung by Christopher, my son, played by Mark, as a gift to us all, as a reminder of the way of suffering. We enter into the 3 days, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, the Way of the Cross. Christ speaks, "These 10 steps that you are now about to walk, you do not take alone. I walk with you. Though you are who you are and I am who I am, yet we are truly one in Christ. And therefore my way of the cross 2,000 years ago and your way now are also one. But note this difference. My life was incomplete until I crowned it by my death and rising to life again. Your 10 steps will only be complete when you have crowned them by your life." The scriptures speak. "So when Pilate saw that he was gaining nothing, but rather that a riot was beginning, he took water and washed his hands before the crowd, saying, 'I am innocent of this man's blood. See to it yourself.' And all the people answered, 'His blood be on us and on our children.' Then he released for them Barabbas, and having whipped Jesus, delivered him to be crucified."
We reply, "My Jesus, Lord, obedience cost you your life. For me, it cost an act of will, no more. And yet, how hard it is for me to bend. Remove the blinders from my eyes, that I may see that it is you whom I obey in all who govern me. Lord, it is you."
O Savior of the world, by your cross and precious blood, you have redeemed us.
Save us and help us, we pray to you, O Lord.
Then the soldiers of the governor took Jesus into the praetorium. And they gathered the whole battalion before him, and they stripped him and put a scarlet robe upon him, and plaited a crown of thorns. They put it on his head and put a reed in his right hand, And kneeling before him, they mocked him, saying, "Hail, King of the Jews!" And they spat upon him, took the reed, and struck him on the head. And when they had mocked him, they stripped him of the robe, put on his own clothes, and led him away to crucify him.
My Jesus, Lord, I take my daily cross. I welcome the challenges that often mark my day, the choices and the temptations not to choose, the hopes and disappointments, the successes and setbacks, the tensions and cares, which lead me to acknowledge my dependence on you alone. Remind me often that in carrying my cross, I carry yours with you. And though I bear a sliver only of your cross, you carry all of mine, except a sliver in return.
O Savior of the world, by your cross and precious blood, you have redeemed us.
Save us and help us. We pray to you, O Lord.
And they compelled a passerby, Simon of Cyrene, who was coming in from the country, the father of Alexander and Rufus, to carry his cross. And they brought him to the place called Golgotha, which means the place of a skull. And they offered him wine mingled with myrrh, but he did not take it.
Lord, make me realize that every time I dry a dish, pick up an object off the floor, assist a child in some small task, or give another preference in traffic or the store, each time I feed the hungry, clothe the naked, teach the ignorant, or lend my hand in any way, it matters not to whom. My name is Simon, and the kindness I extend to them, I really give to you.
O Savior of the world, by your cross and precious blood, you have redeemed us.
Save us and help us. We pray to you, O Lord.
And there followed him a great multitude of the people and of women who bewailed and lamented him. But Jesus, turning to them, said, "Daughters of Jerusalem, do not weep for me, but weep for yourselves and for your children. For behold, the days are coming when they will say, 'Blessed are the barren, and the wombs that never bore, and the breasts that never gave nourishment.' Then they will begin to say to the mountains, 'Fall on us,' and to the hills, 'Cover us.' For if they do this when the wood is green, what will happen when it is dry?"
My Jesus, your compassion in your passion is beyond compare. Lord, teach me, help me learn. Even in your darkest hour and in pain, you would love me enough to warn me of the coming judgment. Give to me urgency in my concern for others. Lord, help me to love, even as you have loved me.
O Savior of the world, by your cross and precious blood, you have redeemed us.
Save us and help us. We pray to you, O Lord.
When the soldiers had crucified Jesus, they took his garments and made four parts, one for each shoulder. Also his tunic. But the tunic was without seam, woven from top to bottom. So they said to one another, "Let us not tear it, but cast lots for it to see whose it shall be." This was to fulfill the scriptures. "They parted my garments among them, and for my clothing they cast lots."
My Lord, I offer you my all, whatever I possess and more, myself. Detach me from the craving for prestige, position, wealth. Root out of me all trace of envy of my neighbor who has more than I. Release me from the vice of pride, my longing to exalt myself, and lead me to the lowest place. May I be poor in spirit, Lord, so that I can be rich in you.
O Savior of the world, by your cross and precious blood, you have redeemed us.
Save us and help us, we pray to you, O Lord.
And when they came to the place which is called the Skull, where they crucified him, and the criminals, one on the right and one on the left. And Jesus said, Father, forgive them, for they know not what they do. And they cast lots to divide his garments. There was also an inscription over him, This is the King of the Jews.
My God, I look at you and I think, is my soul worth this much? What can I give you in return? I here and now accept for all my life your forgiveness and the strength which that imparts to times of temptation and times of suffering, to all my living and my dying.
O Savior of the world, by your cross and precious blood, you have redeemed us.
Save us and help us, we pray to you, O Lord.
It was now the sixth hour, and there was darkness over the whole land until the ninth hour, while the sun lights failed. And the curtain of the temple was torn in two. Then Jesus, crying with a loud voice, said, Father, into thy hands I commit my spirit. And having said this, he breathed his last.
My Jesus, God, what can I do or say? Into thy hands I commit my spirit. I offer you my trust in all my living and in my dying, accepting now the way which you have gone before us and for us. My God, forsake us not. We know not what we do.
O Savior of the world, by your cross and precious blood, you have redeemed us.
Save us and help us, we pray to you, O Lord.
Since it was the day of preparation, in order to prevent the bodies from remaining on the cross of the Sabbath, for the Sabbath was a high holy day, the Jews asked Pilate that their legs might be broken and that they might be taken away. So the soldiers came and broke the legs of the first and of the other who had been crucified with him. But when they came to Jesus, they saw that he was already dead. They did not break his legs. But one of the soldiers pierced his side with a spear, and at once there came out blood and water. He who saw it has borne witness. His testimony is true. And he knows that he tells the truth, that you also may believe. For these things took place that the scripture might be fulfilled. Not a bone of him shall be broken. And again, another scripture says, they shall look on him whom they have pierced. After this, Joseph of Arimathea, who was a disciple of Jesus, but secretly for fear of the Jews, asked Pilate that he might take away the body of Jesus. And Pilate gave him leave. So he came and took away his body.
I beg you, Lord, help me accept the partings that must come. From friends who go away, my children leaving home, and most of all, my dear ones when you call them to yourself. Then give me the grace to say, as it has pleased you, Lord, to take them home. I bow to your most holy will. Grant them eternal joy.
O Savior of the world, by your cross and precious blood, you have redeemed us.
Save us and help us, we pray to you, O Lord.
Now in the place where he was crucified, there was a garden, and in the garden, a new tomb, where no one had ever been laid. So because of the Jewish day of preparation, as the tomb was close at hand, they laid Jesus there. The women who had come with him from Galilee followed and saw the tomb and how his body was laid to rest. Then they returned and prepared spices and ointments. On the Sabbath they rested, according to the commandments.
My Jesus, Lord, you know my spirit is as willing as my flesh is weak. The teaching you imparted, the sufferings you bore, the works of love you did in your short life on earth, let me also impart and bear and do through you. But I need help, Lord. Help me.
O Savior of the world, by your cross and precious blood, you have redeemed us.
Save us and help us, we pray to you, O Lord.
After the Sabbath day was over, Mary and Salome brought spices to go and anoint the body of Jesus. Very early on Sunday morning, they went to the grave. On the way, they said to one another, "Who will roll away the stone from the entrance to the grave?" Then they looked up and saw that the stone had already been rolled back. So they entered the grave, where they saw an angel wearing a white robe, and they were filled with fear. But the angel said, "Don't be alarmed. I know you are looking for Jesus who was nailed to the cross. He is not here. He has been raised. Look, here's the place where they placed him. Now go and give this message to his disciples, including Peter. He is going to Galilee ahead of you. There you will see him, just as he told you." So they went out and ran from the grave because fear and trembling were upon them. They said nothing to anyone because they were afraid.
They were afraid, Lord, and so are we sometimes. Living can be more fearful than dying sometimes. Help me, Lord, to accept your living and the newness of life to which your life raises me, raises us. Help me to give my life to the great adventure of love which your life bespeaks. Into thy hands I commit my spirit. Alleluia.
I told you at the start my life was not complete until I crowned it by my death and my rising to life again. Your way is not complete until you crown it by your life. Accept each moment as it comes to you, with faith and trust that all that happens can have my mark upon it. A cry or a whisper of hope and courage, "Come in, Lord Jesus." That's all it takes, a breathing in your heart. "Come in, Lord Jesus. Thy will be done." So seek me not in far-off places. I am close at hand. Your workbench, office, kitchen, these are altars where you offer love, and I am with you there. Go now, take up your cross, and with your life, complete your way with me. Thank you.
Via Dolorosa al Calvario a morir. The blood that cleansed the souls of all men made its way.